Bam, it's true.
In this video, we are going to learn how to factor by grouping. Not the most common type of factoring. We have, you know, factoring sum and difference of cubes, the difference of squares, and we just do a lot of factoring with regular quadratic equations. The first step of factoring, though, is to try and factor out that monomial. I have a video on that as well if you're struggling with it. But in this case, all four of our examples that we're going to work through are going to be factoring by grouping. Now, problems that involve factoring by grouping generally have more than just two or three terms. They usually have like four. So all my examples are going to have four terms, and we're going to, just factor by grouping. Now, it's kind of hard to like describe steps to do this process, so I'm going to just hopefully show you with these examples and help you understand how to do this process. We are going to be looking at these expressions, or I can even write an equation at the end of this, or set this expression equal to zero and make it be an equation. And we're going to go ahead and solve this equation by factoring. And again, that'll be factored by grouping. So factoring by grouping is going to need to recall your skills of factoring out a monomial, one of the very first things we teach you when we introduce factoring. And I'm drawing this line down here because we're going to look at the first two and the last two terms separately. So kind of forgetting the rest of this equation is here, just looking at the 2x cubed minus 4x squared, what can be divided out or pulled out of those first two terms? Well, they have leading coefficients that are both even, so we can divide out a 2. And getting ahead of myself there. So 2 will divide into 2 and 4 evenly. Now, that's for the coefficients. Do these two terms both have any common variables? Well, clearly they both have an x, and how many can you take out of both? How many x's can you ask both of these terms to give up? Well, this has three of them, as our exponent shows, and this has two. So I can take out an x squared from each of these terms. Now, I'm assuming if we're doing factoring by grouping that you have gotten comfortable factoring out a monomial. So I'm not going to actually show the step where we're dividing out this 2x squared. I'm just going to verbally do it. 2x cubed. Well, 2 divided by 2 is 1. And we can write that leading coefficient there or not. It's not going to really do anything. We have x cubed, which means that there's 3 x's in this term, and we're taking these 3 x's and dividing out 2 of them. So x cubed divided by x squared is going to leave you with just one of those x's left in that term. Now, going on to the second term, we have negative 4 divided by 2 is going to be negative 2, and x squared divided by x squared is 1. So this is bothering me that this one's in here. So we have 2x squared times x minus 2. Now, this four-term expression, or now this equation that I've set it equal to 0, if it is truly factorable by grouping, then I need to be able to factor out something from the last two terms, and I need this x minus 2 to show up again. If I cannot take a common factor out of these last two terms and make the x minus 2 show up again, then either I've made a mistake. Certainly if you're in a section in your textbook that is, you know, factoring by grouping section, then you've probably made a mistake. If you're in a higher level class, then maybe this just doesn't factor by grouping. So we have a coefficients again of 3 and 6. These are both of these numbers are divisible by 3. And see, my x here is positive, and my next x term is positive. My number, my constant, is negative 2, and over here my constant is negative 6. So my signs are good. I just need to take the 3 and factor it out of those last two terms. So I'm going to factor out a positive 3, and 3x divided by, I'm looking over here. 3x divided by 3 is 1x, and negative 6 divided by 3 is negative 2. Okay, excellent. Now, I have, again, pulled the 2x squared out of the first two terms. I have pulled a 3 or divided out or factored out a 3 from my last two terms. And here I've got a matching factor. I have this x minus 2. Going back to the original problem, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 terms on the left side of this equation. Well, now I've got a lot of pluses and minuses still going on in my second line, but these parentheses are locking that x minus 2 together. So this is has become one big, rather complicated term. This is not, but this is not like two or three terms in here. This is 2 times something with the parentheses locking that x minus 2 together. Addition and subtraction separate terms. Again, with the parentheses locking this together, this is all acting as one term plus this second term here. Now, these two big terms separated by that addition sign, these two big terms both have a common factor of x minus 2. So just like I factored out 2x squared from these two terms, just like I factored out 3 from these two terms, I'm going to factor out an x minus 2 from these two terms. So we're going to see that common factor and divide it out. 2x squared times x minus 2 divided by x minus 2 is just going to leave us with the 2x squared. And 3 times x minus 2 divided by x minus 2 is just going to leave us the plus 3. And that's equal to 0. Now, for these two factors I just finished factoring by grouping on my first example. For these two factors to multiply together to equal 0, then one of these two factors must be equal to 0. So either x minus 2 equals 0 or 2x squared plus 3 equals 0. Well, if I try and solve this, we're going to subtract both sides by 3. We're going to need to divide both sides by 2. And I can go ahead and just stop, because after I divide both sides by 2, I'm going to get x squared is equal to negative 3 over 2. Well, unless you're studying complex numbers or imaginary solutions, you cannot square root a negative number. So this is done. If I come over here and I add 2 to both sides, I have the answer of x equals 2. So I found a real solution, and if I want to verify it, I can take this value of 2 and plug it in through my original equation and still make sure that I get that answer of 0. Over here, I've got x cubed minus 20x squared minus 2x minus 5. We're not going to take that extra step of setting this equal to 0 and solving the equation. I just wanted to show you, that's generally what we do factoring for, is to solve equations. Here we're just going to factor this this four-term polynomial, this four-term expression. If you feel like you got that, you might want to stop the video and practice this on your own and make sure you can get it right. Well, what common factors do 8 and 20 have? Well, they're both even, so they're both divisible by 2, but I need to take out the biggest number. These two are both divisible by 4, so we're going to take out that 4. They both have x's, and we can take out the lowest exponent, so we can take out x squared. And 8x cubed divided by 4x squared, well, 8 divided by 4 is 2. And if we have 3 x's and we're taking 2 of them out through division, that's going to leave us with just 1. 20 divided by positive 4 is positive 5. And x squared divided by x squared is, well, nothing. It cancels out, so we just get 2x plus 5. Now, see, here we have a positive 2x and a positive 5, but my last two terms, and you might want to sort of visually separate those two terms, we got negative 2x and negative 5. I need them to be positive, so we're going to divide out a negative 1. Negative 2x divided by negative 1 is positive 2x. Negative 5 divided by negative 1 is positive 5. Sorry for the interruption there. So now we've got, again, this minus sign separating these two big terms. We had the negative 2 divided by negative 1 is positive 2x, and the negative 5 divided by negative 1 is positive 5. Now, these two terms, okay, both have common factors of 2x plus 5, so we're going to factor out that common factor of 2x plus 5, and let's just show that we're doing that. 4x squared times 2x plus 5 divided by 2x plus 5 is going to be 4x squared, and negative 1 times 2x plus 5 divided by 2x plus 5 is negative 1. Now, we're not done factoring this. You probably have also recently not only talked about factoring out monomials, but you probably should have recently discussed or learned how to factor a difference of two perfect squares. So we're going to have this as 2x plus 5. The square root of this first term is 2x. The square root of 4 is 2. The square root of x squared is x. So we have 2x. The square root of 1 is 1. So we have 2x plus 1 times 2x minus 1. And that is our example finished. We had a little bit of factoring by grouping and a little bit of review there of factoring a difference of squares. I got two more examples for you. Now, this third example looks very similar to the previous two, and it is, but it poses a little bit of a special problem that causes my students to make some common mistakes with it. So, let's see what happens. Again, we have four terms, we have a third degree, so hopefully this is factorable by grouping. And between the 6 and 7, there's no common factors, so all we have is the ability to factor out an x squared. So we take that out. 6x cubed divided by x squared is equal to 6x, because there was 3 and I took 2 out. Minus 7x squared divided by x squared, well, we just get negative 7. Okay, now, here's the tricky part with this problem. When you factor by grouping, you must show that you're factoring out a common monomial from the first two terms, and you must show that you're factoring out a common monomial from the second two terms. Well, I already have a perfect match, 6x minus 7 and 6x minus 7. Well then, what? That's is where the mistake generally happens with these problems. First example, I could factor out a 3. The second example, I could factor out a negative 1. This example, I must show with factoring by grouping that I'm factoring something out of the last two terms. Otherwise, I'm not going to know how to finish it. I can't just write a set of parentheses and do 6x minus 7. So I need to divide something out of these two terms that does not change the way that they look or change their value. And they have no common factors anyway. So what can I divide out of these numbers that is going to keep them the same? I can divide by 1. So we're going to show that we're dividing out a positive 1, and that is for academic purposes. I need to see that plus 1 so I can, you know, finish my factoring by grouping process. So 6 divided by 1 is just still going to be 6x, and negative 7 divided by 1 is just going to be negative 7. So it appears that nothing has changed, but see, I got that plus sign separating my two terms that I once again need to factor out. Let's see. We have a common factor in our two terms of 6x minus 7. So if I divide out 6x minus 7 from the first term, I'm left with just x squared. And if I divide out 6x minus 7 from the second term, I'm just left with the positive 1. And, well, this is done. I have finished my factoring by grouping. And again, I just showed this to you because when the students see that match, a lot of times they don't know how to continue. Now this question here, I've got many, many variables in the same algebraic expression, and but it's four terms, and generally when I'm given four terms and I'm asked to factor, that is a factor by grouping process. This is would be no really equation that I could solve, even if I set it equal to zero. This is just a problem where we want to practice that factoring by grouping process again. So these first two terms, AB, leading coefficient of 1, so there's no value, numerical value you can factor out, but these two terms both have a factor of A, so we're going to divide that out. AB divided by A is just going to be B, and minus 2AC, well 2AC divided by A means I'm taking that A and dividing it out, so we're just left with negative 2C. Okay, now, can I take something again out of these last two terms to make this show up again? Well, these two terms both have a factor of 3, so we're going to factor out that positive 3. 3b divided by 3 is equal to b, and negative 6 divided by positive 3 is negative 2, C. And voila, I have a matching factor in each of these two terms. So we're going to get, again, take that out. So we're going to factor out that B minus 2C. And we have A plus 3. And that is the end of my video. So, I'm Mr. True. Bah! Go do your homework.